Dr. David Fisher is the president of the Canadian Society of Allergy and Clinical Immunology. He shares information regarding the over-reliance on first-generation antihistamines and related side effects by Canadians suffering from seasonal allergies or allergic rhinitis, an inflammation of the nose, who are seeking relief from common aggravating symptoms such as a runny or stuffy nose, sneezing, or red, itchy, watery eyes.
At the Canadian Society of Allergy and Clinical Immunology, we certainly have been frustrated over the years with the over-reliance of various physicians prescribing first-generation antihistamines, and technically pharmacists recommending them as well as one of the first drugs of choice. We tend to view them as the last drug that we would tend to recommend to our patients.
In use for more than 75 years, first-generation antihistamines are widely available over-the-counter. They would include Benadryl, Chlorotripilon, and Atarax, which is available by prescription. These medications cause a significant amount of drowsiness.
Interestingly, from a drowsiness perspective, Benadryl is sold as a sleep aid. So it's, you can buy 50 milligrams of Benadryl as a sleep aid, but you're also taking it for your allergy symptoms during the daytime, which is not making a lot of sense.
While antihistamines may help you to fall asleep, overall sleep quality is usually not very good.
So the sleep that you do well with is called REM sleep, where you're getting dreams. That doesn't happen when you're taking a first-generation antihistamine. So people think they're doing a good thing because they're taking the medication that will help them to fall asleep, but in fact, they're actually not getting good sleep.
Benadryl should not be used when driving or operating heavy machinery, but also when mental faculties are required to be optimal.
There is a definite hangover effect in children. There are a few studies that were done that looked at exam performance in children on first-generation antihistamines. They did very poorly, actually. You also have something called anticholinergic side effects. So those are things where you get dry mouth, dry eyes, dry nose. You get a lot of significant dryness, and you can actually have other side effects, which include dizziness, and not just drowsiness, but dizziness during the day. And you get senior citizens taking these medications. They're at risk for falling. They are at risk for having a lot of urinary retention issues and things that people aren't always thinking about.
There are options for allergy sufferers, which provide effective symptom control but should not make you drowsy. These are second-generation antihistamines, commonly known as Allegra, Arius, Claritin, and Reactine, mostly available over-the-counter at your pharmacy for some time in Canada. Additionally, Reactine is available by prescription in a higher dosage.
The only drug that's different dose-wise on prescription is Reactine. So Reactine, prescription-wise, is 20 milligrams. Over-the-counter strength is 10. So therefore, you are getting a slightly higher dose of Reactine. The drawback of Reactine at 20 milligrams is that it makes about 20% of people drowsy. So it's supposed to be non-drowsy. It's potentially drowsy.
Prescription strength Reactine and Benadryl are not prescribed for pilots.
There was a study where they were looking at plane crashes, and they looked at the pilot, and they were examining the blood of pilots, and 6% of them had Benadryl in their bloodstream. So we know that certain drugs like Benadryl, drowsy medications, are things that should be essentially forbidden for pilots, truck drivers, bus drivers, etc.
For the first time in 20 years, there are two new antihistamines available in Canada by prescription.
So after quite a number of years, 20 years, we actually have two new antihistamines in Canada at pretty much exactly the same time. So they're both on prescription, and one is rupatadine or Rupal.
Rupal is the only new prescription indicated for children ages 2 or older.
And the other is bilastine or Blexten.
Blexten is indicated for patients 12 years and older.
So they're both on prescription, they're once daily, and they're quite non-drowsy. So those are all things to their benefit as well.
In clinical trials among second-generation prescription antihistamines, there are differences in the rates of sedation. As well, one should also consider whether a product is processed in the liver, known as metabolism. Drugs that need to be processed by the liver may lead to an increased likelihood of drug interactions. Dr. Fisher has one final message to share regarding the use of antihistamines within allergies and allergic rhinitis.
I want patients to know that I do have some concerns if they're taking a lot of Benadryl on multiple levels. I want them to be aware that these other medications are available on prescription. You can seek them out, especially if you do have drug plan coverage. And I want them to know that they are basically safe, and a lot of people are afraid of taking antihistamines on a regular basis. There's very little data to support that regular taking of them is a problem. For any patient who's doing any of these new antihistamines, you should speak to your pharmacist. There are some potentials for drug interactions, and that's what your pharmacist is for.
Please always speak with your pharmacist for counsel regarding antihistamines and potential drug reactions or side effects.